that y'all had beef at one point of time and shit like y'all fought. So how did that go?
I'm gonna let that man tell y'all.
Shit, man. So you know, all three of us had a class together. We used to change classes, so we had Miss Blackman, Mr. Anderson class. Mr. Anderson was a science teacher. Miss Blackman being social studies teacher. So you know, yeah, that's how that went. But yeah, so we was in class one day, you know. All us, we been young, immature ass niggas, man. So we all low-key hating on each other. So it's just like, I don't know, man. This one day, we was talking shit to each other. Then, I don't know, man. He came, bust my shit in the back of my foot. I was like, oh, shit. I can't look like no bitch. So I had to turn around, push this nigga, kick this nigga back, one or two. Yeah, I turn around and then catch my ass about a 4-piece, 5-piece. I was like, oh shit. You know, I'm in the bitch. So, you know, I went to go chill. I started tearing up and shit. Not because I'm no bitch. I was just mad as fuck because I ain't know what to do. So, yeah, so that's when, you know, Miss Anderson asked what's happening. Then we just ended up going to the office. And yeah, that's how that shit went. So, you know, that been in second grade, that been third grade.
Okay. So y'all fought. Then after y'all fought, how did y'all find out y'all was related?
I came to this nigga house. Alright, so I'm riding my damn bike down the street, right? And I see this bitch outside. He sitting on the porch. I'm like, oh shit, that nigga that go to my school. So, you know, I ride up trying to be all friendly and shit, tell him shit that happened at school, you know, I've been over that shit. Come to find out, this nigga dog had died, so you know he was kind of sad. So shit, we out there talking for like a good minute. We go in the house. This nigga house was nice as fuck. I ain't gonna lie. That bitch had everything. That bitch had stereo system, game system, and we been popping back then. Yeah. Actually, we been playing monster trucks up on that bitch. Next thing you know, that's when I go home. Cause before that, came around that bitch looking for me. She knew who the fuck I was at. So, you know, I got my ass whooped when I got home. But she was like, you know that's your cousin, right? And I'm like, what? Nah, you lying. And she was like, yeah, that's your cousin. You smacked the fuck out your cousin. And shit, ever since that day, bro, didn't like that.
Okay. So, like, you know, fought, found your cousins. So, after y'all found out was cousins and y'all good, cool and everything, y'all was tight. I say, skip some years, kind of to present day, but it's still in the past now. So, like, how did all the rap stuff started up?
Alright, so, we all came together. I brought up the idea. I was like, hey, bro, I kind of want to start rapping. You know, I had a little notepad full of little notes. I ain't the shit back then, you know. I couldn't rap for shit. But, like, this nigga had a piano, so he was trying to make a little beat. You know, he had want to be a little producer. So he been back there making a beat. Back there, you know, fucking with paper and damn tea leaves. Thought we were fucking smoking. We ain't doing shit. But, yeah, and then, like, so, we fought with it for a little bit, but then it shit kind of fell off. But
okay. Then, like, so, like, they caught my attention when you say smoking with tea leaves and paper. So, when y'all was smoking that shit, y'all really thought y'all was high?
Hell yeah.
You used to be faking like a motherfucking dog.
I'm high as fuck.
Okay. Let me see. Let's fast forward past when y'all started. Like, how y'all, when the first time y'all went to the studio and where was it? Like, how was it that night?
That day? Connects.
Oh, yeah, we had this nigga, his name Dre. Nigga from Chicago, he cool and shit. Shout out nigga Guapo Mahancho. Appreciate that shit. So, this is what happened. So, you know, this nigga been rapping. So, he been rapping for a minute. So, you know what I'm saying? First, me and the cameraman, we was like, you know, we ain't really with this shit, you know. But now it's like he started. We see this nigga keep going harder and harder with this shit. So he's like, yeah, we got to now. You know what I'm saying? This shit might, you know, niggas who ain't really feeling shit, then niggas start popping and shit. So he was like, we might as well do that shit. So that's when, you know, I hit this nigga Guapo up. I thought, yo, what's up with it, man? So he was like, yo, come through this weekend. So we came through this weekend. And it was in the, he had a bass. Shout out Dave G. We appreciate that shit, bro. So yeah, his brother Dave, he was like, we walk in the house, he had this big ass studio, like that shit just knocking, shit. The nigga had all the lights, all that shit. I've been feeling that shit.
So the shit was nice.
The shit was nice, bro. So,
legit?
Yeah, legit as hell.
Good quality.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Nice crispy.
Yeah, SoundCloud, OG Gang, clips, all that shit. You know, check that shit out. But yeah, that's how that went. So we ended up making like 3 songs. You know, Lico made one by his dad, you know. RIP, you know what I'm saying? So that's how that shit went, man. Yeah, that's when we came up with shit. But you know, like I said, that's our first time in the studio. So I think we did good for our first time, but we still got improvement to make, you know what I'm saying? Like, so yeah.
But let's get this on straight. Our first shit, I mean, besides Clip, the other shit, it wasn't all that. But like, it was something to put out there, you know.
Ladies, our first time.
Yeah, let them niggas know what the fuck's up with the shit, you know. But shit, as time went on, we kind of progressed with the shit. You know, got better word position and stuff like that. You know. So, for myself, though, I kind of like took that shit like more serious because I thought about like ways that we could like make it out here, bro. Like, niggas think this shit a game. Like, we do this shit for real, bro. This shit ain't no pretending or nothing, bro. Like, we really out here trying to like make something of ourselves. We ain't trying to be like these niggas, you know, selling weed or nah, I ain't with that shit. See, I'm trying to make like a positive influence on people. Like, you see, where I come from, bro, like, shit was kind of hard. I ain't gonna lie. I just found out that the dad that I thought I got, that's not even my dad. Like, I had a dad that was in jail for like all my life. I never knew that nigga. But like, I recently found out who he was. You know, we got together, talk a little bit. Nigga helped me out, you know, throw a nigga quick 600. It ain't been much, but hey, for a young buck, that's something right there, bro.
Shout out DeAndre, dad, make him a little star, you know what I'm saying? Bro.
Yeah. So, I know it been tough. So when you find out that, you know, even the father that you stand with, even though he's not your biological father, so how do you still look at him?
I look at him as a role model. You know, like, he was there when I felt like I ain't had no one. All them days, me being bad, you know, getting kicked out of school, getting suspended, all that. And he was like, you got to calm that down because I want better for you. And I was like, well, what do you care? You ain't my dad anyway. And he was like, I ain't your dad, but I'm here for you and stuff like that. And so, like, you know.
Like, how the females treating y'all, man?
Man, don't even get me started with that shit, bro.
How the females, man? How they treating y'all?
Man, these bitches ain't shit.
well.
Shit, they ain't worth. Bro, they ain't worth the ground we walk on, bro. Real talk, like, they be so, I ain't gonna lie, we all got the same problem, you know. We all be looking for somebody down, you know, loyal and shit. But at the same time, we young as fuck, so, like, we can't really keep up to that mentality. Like, I could see us, like, what, 2-3 years from now, you know, probably booed up, probably, like, actually having a real relationship. But now, nah, that shit ain't happening, bro. Like, I had to learn from experience, bro. Sometimes you gotta let that shit ride.
Okay, so like, I understand where you're coming from. So like, what experiences, if you want to tell, what experiences you been through?
Ah, shit, like, I don't think I want to explain that right now, you know?
So you don't want to, okay, I understand you want to get that to the world. So Dylan.
So, you know, it's a lot of niggas out here, you know, they say, you know, bitch ain't shit. I respect them, you know, some of them ain't. But, you know, there's a lot of females out here who will really be, you know, down for you and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I respect all of, you know, the young women out there who, you know, grinding for themselves and shit, trying to be independent and shit, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to all them beautiful women out there, you know what I'm saying? So, but yeah,
I ain't really got much to say, you know. I got a little shorty, you know what I'm saying? That's my boo. I love you. You know who you is. Saying no name, you feel me?
Alright.
Shit. I mean, you know, I still got love. It ain't changed, you know. So, hey, I ain't even mad, though, but, like, at the same time, I still gotta keep my distance, cause, you know, I gotta focus on me now. I gotta be about me instead of, like, worrying about all this other shit that don't really matter like that.
Okay. So, I understand y'all trying to focus on y'all, you know, focus on us. I mean, Dale got a shorty.
Yeah, shout out my baby again. You know what I'm saying? You know you really.
My man's praying. He been through a couple of twists here and there, but now he back solid.
But shit, you know, I still get shown mad love now. I ain't gonna lie about that.
No, man, tough.
I still get shown mad love, you know. I mean, shit, we done been through some shit, but, you know, she still called me, you know, we still talk.
Okay.
We good.
So it's like, y'all still friend terms, but y'all good.
Yeah.
Like, okay.
I wouldn't say friend, because, like, you know, if I need her, you know, she there for me.
Okay.
If she need me, you know, I'm there for her and shit like that.
So it's a little deeper than that.
Yeah, a little deeper than that.
Okay. Well, I'm going to ask probably one more question for both of y'all. Part in. So, like, what's, like, let's see, I want to get something good. Like, what's the best thing that y'all think y'all did with each other? Like, funnest, wildest, craziest type thing. Yeah.
The shit we doing right now, man.
Every day I get to spend with my niggas, I feel, you know, I cherish that shit, you know what I'm saying? The niggas out here dying and shit, you know what I'm saying? But I'm gonna have my niggas back, though, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, every day I'm with my niggas, you know, that's cool for me.
Yeah. What about you, Preen?
We done been through some wild shit, bro. Hey, look, like I said, hey, I love this nigga, bro. Like, this nigga always kept that shit real with me, bro. Like,
always.
Stat, like, when I'm in the wrong, you know, that nigga come check me.
Since Preem got more in detail about his life and how he grew up, where you from? Hey.
Shit, you know, I ain't gonna lie, bro. I hate niggas who be like, who say they something from somewhere else, nigga. I'm from fucking Sumter, South Carolina, born and raised, you know what I'm saying? Niggas be flexing like they from some exotic type of shit, like somewhere. Like, I'm from ATL, nigga, shut the fuck up.
Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? They be real with your shit. Like, myself, I actually got family that's like there or been there. Like, they be like, I'm from Atlanta. And then you ask them what part of Atlanta you're from, they say Atlanta. I'm like, nah, bro. We mean, like, you from Brunswick or Stone Mountain or somewhere over there. Like,
fuck that nigga in Brunswick.
Yeah, that nigga in Brunswick. That nigga fake ass nigga. Like, real talk. Like,
fuck.
I got some. I get more detail with that, you know, later on.
Right, we ain't gonna speak on that bitch.
Yeah.
Okay. But, so, deal.
Yo.
Like, what's something tough or hard, I would say, that you had to face once upon a time in your life?
Bruh, you know, like I said, bruh, we some young niggas, bruh. We ain't really, you know, it's niggas out here who really be through this shit. I ain't never really been through nothing, man. I think, like, the hardest thing I had to overcome probably was when my great-grandma died. I mean, you know, we were close, but she was already old when I was born, so I ain't like, you know, RIP my grandma though. But that probably was like the hardest thing. I saw everybody be crying, bro. You know, so that shit hit me, bro.
So what about, I want to say, because I heard, actually I was with you, like, how do you feel when, like, we both, that day could have almost died, like,
yeah, so, you know, one day, we was like 12, 13, you know what I'm saying? We was on some bad shit, man. So, you know, you can tell us shit, bro. We had little BB guns and shit like that, bro. So, you can tell us shit, bro. So, you know, we fucked around, start walking. We was like, yo, Leak, bro, let's get this BB gun. Start shooting birds and shit. That's when me, Leak, and Devin, we start walking around and shit in the hood. That's when I saw this loose, stray-ass dog. Shit started barking at us and shit. I stand in some lady's yard, so I was like, you know, fuck it. I'm gonna pop this bitch.
My nigga Leak over here like, nah, bro, don't do it. Don't do it, bro. I like, fuck that shit. I aimed that motherfucker. Shot that dog, bro. She started running. Then some lady came outside. Was like, yo, why you shoot our dog? She called us niggas and shit, all that shit. But we was already dipping. So we saw the bitch come outside, so we already dipped. But we heard, you stupid niggas. That's all I fucking heard, bro. So then that's when we haul ass and shit. Then nigga eloped though. You know, fuck that nigga too. But fuck that bitch, nigga. So that nigga, we just tried to hide out, man. So that's when I was like, bro, I gotta go back home, bro, cause this shit crazy. So we, you know, my niggas ride down the ride for a nigga, so they ain't gonna let me go alone. So, you know, they fuck around. And you know, we were trying to take the back way back home. That's when we heard that nigga car down the street, so we haul ass. We hide behind somebody's house. And Sunday we scared as fuck, bro. So we been hiding behind their house. So we heard the car go down some other way. That's when we dirt behind these people's house, start getting down the street. You know what I'm saying? So we start getting down the street. That's when we were walking, trying to hurry up and get my crib so we'd be safe. Nigga, you turn the corner. And nigga swerve out the cut. That's when he hop out the car, his little bitch in the car. Pop out, he had little 9 on him or some shit. What the fuck it was? I know that shit. Fuck that nigga, bro. I know what the fuck it was. But he came out. He said, y'all shot my fucking dog. Shit like that, man. Shit was just crazy, bro. So, you know, my nigga Leak on him, his cousin Devin, shout out Devin too. You know, they had my back, bro. So they was like, yo, nigga, chill, don't do that shit. Then, you know, this nigga young, he said all that shit. So he just ended up taking my fucking shoes. You know what I'm saying? They ain't been no hard shoes. You know, they still been in my shoes though, but shit like, damn. But you know what I'm saying? That shit ain't going, like, to the day, bro. If you want that shit, bro, that shit ain't going no more. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so that's how that shit went.
Okay. So, like, all right, so shit, this is where it all started, man?
Yeah, bitch, right here. If you got some questions, like, around the area, I can explain some things for you.
Yeah. So how y'all got to this place, man?
First, I stayed in the country. Some things were going on between the parents. I don't get too much into that.
Yeah.
That's like a personal type level, so.
Yeah.
I was there, staying with my dad, and my grandma, and then moved my mom, full staff. It's still kind of on the cross, but I was standing in the chase. Then I said, well, around 7. I was still going here though, but like around 7, that's when I moved to the neighborhood with my boys.
Yeah.
And at the time, I would say she wasn't really strict. She just wouldn't want me out in the streets and shit.
Yeah.
But like, so I just wanted to go outside around the yard or across the street. My little bro, shout out to Ray.
Yeah, and shout out Ray.
I've been on my niggas since school, but I just really couldn't spend time with them niggas outside of school. Then I hit about 11. When I hit 11, that's when I could start going out. I remember praying, this nigga could have been go out.
Yeah.
Ride bikes every fucking well.
Yeah.
And he happened to come through my block. You know, I'm love, like, okay, it's my block, but that's my nigga, so it's good. And then I could finally leave. And now he took me to Jose house. Like, okay, this nigga stay right here.
Yeah.
And then, since then, we all, you know, smashed it out. But we been fucking with each other since then, huh? It just, when we started really kicking outside of school, you know.
Yeah. Most definitely, man. That shit, man. We gonna have to wrap this shit. So what's going on with y'all niggas, bruh?
See, you know, just bowling. Yeah, man. I'm just like, trying to get the fuck out. You know what I'm saying? That's all we doing, man.
Got a couple questions.
Attitudes. We got plenty answers. Ask away.
So, how long y'all known each other?
I know this nigga 10 plus years, bro.
How long y'all been fucking with each other?
10 plus years, bro.
I mean, you know, they say the longer we've been fucking with each other, you know, we start to look alike. And as we can see, hold on, I don't think they can see clearly.
They see this swag.
As we can see, you know.
But this is a little song,
y'all,
you know.
Y'all niggas.
I'm ready for hey, business. Like, school helping me get to the money. So,
school got a lot of opportunities, opening a lot of doors, man. So all you gotta do, man, for the people who watching, man, you know what I'm saying, just, you know, chase your dream, man.
And Cash Cup Productions, all we trying to do is, you know, tell y'all about our life, everyday type stuff, and inspire some people, and lead y'all on, you know, the right path.
Y'all plan on, like, after y'all finish high school, y'all plan on going to college?
Yeah. In Atlanta.
I see how y'all present y'allself, so I got a question.
What's up, bro?
Do y'all have competition at school?
Competition?
I don't know what that is.
I ain't even heard of that.
What is it? Say that again, bro.
Do y'all have competition at y'all school? Like, are there any niggas who come close to y'all?
I didn't hear him. Say that one more time, please.
Are there any people at y'all school that come close to you?
I can't understand the language that you're speaking to me right now.
We don't speak that white nigga.
Yeah.
Ease.
That's not Chinese language you speaking to me, no French, no Spanish. I don't know what that is, bro.
None of that.
Ain't even Dutch, no shit.
Me no comprehend.
Yeah.
All right. So, Dill.
Yo.
I see, you know, you being, you know, the oldest. How your little brother doing, man?
Say, you know what I'm saying, you know. You know, he living, man. You know, I ain't want too many people knowing about my people, so
you know,
keep it at that, you know what I'm saying?
But do you feel like you're a positive role model for your brother?
Of course, man, you know. Like I said, man, you know, doing a little stuff, you know. I know he gonna come out, you know, be a better person than I am, because you know, I done been through a lot. Not that much, but, you know. But you know, I'm gonna show him the right way, though. Because, you know, that is my little brother. I got love for my man, so whatever I can do to help him succeed in life, I'm gonna do that.
And
best in something, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm best in something, best in South Carolina. So I'm imagine if I get my business, take over the world with the shit.
You feel me? Yeah. Well, you know, we always come up with ideas to make money, man. So, like, we 17, we all are 17 now. So, you know, all us getting jobs, man. So we just stacking that paper. Then, you know, by the summer, we're going to have everything. Man. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, clothing line coming soon.
Yeah, most definitely that's going to come.
Yeah, so.
And hopefully that can jump off the charts, you know.
So, as an artist, because, you know, we're all having an up-and-coming, you know, rap career. As an artist, how do you feel like you want to connect with your fans, you know?
Man, giving back, man, you know. Like I said before, man, we coming out of Sumter, South Carolina. You know what I'm saying? We ain't coming from nowhere else, man.
Yeah.
So we're just gonna get back to South Carolina, man. That's all I'm gonna do.